grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you. And good afternoon, and welcome to the two of you. It's taken a long time coming this day, but here we are, and it's lovely to be with you and with family and with friends to celebrate your love for one another and to witness you making these huge lifelong promises to each other. I've had just a couple of things I need to say to you. One is the inevitable advice about masks. It won't be imposed as a rule, but the normal pattern in the Church of England and in Chester Cathedral at the moment is that we wear masks to protect one another, and particularly when we sing, wearing masks whilst singing. I leave that with you, and you make your own decisions. Secondly, Ben and Beth have asked me to request you not to post pictures on social media until they have done so. You'll have to watch their Facebook page, therefore, and you can go ahead once they have done so. But mainly to say to you, we come together at a precious moment and for a lovely day. I hope it touches our hearts and spirits and we have fun. A sentence from the Bible as we begin. God is love, and those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them. We pray together. God of wonder and of joy, grace comes from you, and you alone are the source of life and love. Without you, we cannot please you. Without your love, our deeds are worth nothing. Send your Holy Spirit and pour into our hearts that most excellent gift of love, that we may worship you now with thankful hearts and serve you always with willing minds. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
The congregation, please be seated. We've come together in the presence of God to witness the marriage of Beth and Ben, to ask his blessing on them and to share in their joy. Our Lord Jesus Christ was himself a guest at a wedding in Cana of Galilee, and through his Spirit he is with us now. The Bible teaches us that marriage is a gift of God in creation and a means of his grace, a holy mystery in which man and woman become one flesh. It is God's purpose that as husband and wife give themselves to each other in love throughout their lives, they shall be united in that love as Christ is united with his church. Marriage is given that husband and wife may comfort and help each other, living faithfully together in need and in plenty, in sorrow and in joy. It is given that with delight and tenderness they may know each other in love, and through the joy of their bodily union may strengthen the union of their hearts and lives. It is given as the foundation of family life, in which children may be born and nurtured in accordance with God's will to his praise and glory. In marriage, husband and wife belong to one another, and they begin a new life together in the community. It is a way of life that all should honor, and it must not be undertaken carelessly, lightly, or selfishly, but reverently, responsibly, and after serious thought. This is the way of life, created and hallowed by God, that Ben and Beth are now to begin. They will each give their consent to the other. They will join hands and exchange solemn vows. And in token of this, they will each give and receive a ring. Therefore, on this their wedding day, we pray with them that, strengthened and guided by God, they may fulfill his purpose for the whole of their earthly lives together. First, I am required to ask anyone present who knows a reason why these persons may not lawfully marry to declare it now. You've got away with it so far. Now, the vows that you are about to take are to be made in the presence of God, who is judge of all, and who knows all the secrets of our hearts. Therefore, if either of you knows a reason why you may not lawfully marry, you must declare it now. In which case, let me take those cards off you. You're going to spend your time looking at them. I'll give you them back when you need them, but you don't need them for now. The words that you've got are a very simple response to me. Benjamin Mark, will you take Bethany Hope to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? Bethany Hope, will you take Benjamin Mark to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? And I have the question for all of you. The answer is perhaps intuitive. Will you, the families and friends of Ben and Beth, support and uphold them in their marriage now and in the years to come? Amen. Then let us pray. God our Father, From the beginning, you have blessed creation with abundant life. Pour out your blessings upon Ben and Beth, that they may be joined in mutual love and companionship, in holiness and commitment to each other. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A passage from Les Miserables by Victor Hugo. You can give without loving, but you can never love without giving. The great acts of love are done by those who are habitually performing small acts of kindness. We pardon to the extent that we love. Love is knowing that even when you are alone, you will never be lonely again. And great happiness of life is the conviction that we are loved. Loved for ourselves, and loved even in spite of ourselves.
This reading is taken from Matthew chapter 7, verses 24 to 27. So then, anyone who hears these words of mine and obeys them is like a wise man who built his house on rock. The rain poured down, the rivers flooded over, and the wind blew hard against that house, but it did not fall because it was built on rock. But anyone who hears these words of mine and does not obey them is like a foolish man who built his house on sand. The rain poured down, the rivers flooded over, the wind blew hard against that house, and it fell. And what a terrible fall that was. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Lord, open our eyes to see wonderful things out of your law. Amen. Beth sent me the readings to look at for today, and I saw the fact that it was a reading from Les Miserables, Les Miserables. And I thought, well, short of seven brides for seven brothers, that would have to be one of the readings for today. And I thought, well, I wonder if there's anything else from Les Mis that I can mine, any other wisdom that would be good for a wedding. The problem is, it is a very long book, and I couldn't be bothered reading the whole thing, so I cheated. And I went and found my copy of the musical songbook, and I thought, this is the way to do it. Let's get some wisdom from here, words of wisdom from Les Mis for a wedding. At the end of the day, you're another day older. That's all you can say for the life of the poor. It's a struggle, it's a war. No, not that one. I dreamed a dream. Ah, dreams. Dreams, we like dreams. Dreams are good for weddings. I had a dream my life would be so different from this hell I'm living. No, not there yet. Castle on a cloud. Oh, I like this one. I like this one. Little girl dreaming, something nice, something to look forward to. There's a room that's full of toys. Aha, weddings, yes. There are 100 boys and girls. Goodness. your mums might like that, but no, I wouldn't wish that on anyone. Here we go. Heart full of love. This is the romantic duet, Marius and Cosette. This has got to be something in this. A heart full of love, a heart full of song. I'm doing everything all wrong. Oh, God, for shame, I do not even know your name. That's the Las Vegas wedding. That's no good. On my own. Pretending he's beside me. No, that's delusional. That's not going to work. A little fall of rain can hardly hurt me now. That's the Cathedral Roof Fund, that is. That's nothing to do with the wedding. Drink with me, today's gone by. That's the hen and stag do. Don't want that. I'm running out of options here. Empty chairs at empty tables. Now my friends are dead and gone. My God, what are you serving at the reception? This isn't working at all. I'm going to give up on Les Mis. And instead, I'm going to have to turn to the other reading, which is the Matthew reading. And this story, this passage from Matthew, comes at the end of the Sermon on the Mount. It's the beginning of Jesus' ministry. It's almost like a greatest hits passage. Matthew puts it right at the start of the Gospel. Three chapters of teaching, and much of what is most familiar about Jesus' teaching is in those three chapters. The Lord's Prayer's in there, the Beatitudes, blessed are the peacemakers, for Monty Python fans. The salt, the light, turn the other cheek, don't judge each other. And at the end, Jesus finishes with this encouragement, build your house on these teachings, it's like building a house on the rock. Build it on something else, and it's like building it on sand when the floods come. You'll get washed away. I did spend a bit of time trying to track down that reading from Les Mis and trying to find out where it is. The internet is a wonderful thing. Makes it much easier than flicking through an 800-page book. And if you know Les Mis, you know that the story of Les Mis is one of the great romantic novels, if not the greatest of romantic novels. But it's the story of the tension between law and justice, and grace and love. And law and justice is exemplified in the life of the main character in Jean Valjean in the figure of Inspector Javert, who all the way through the book, all the way through the story, is tracking him down, keeps coming across him, is implacably trying to find justice. We must see justice done. And the figure of grace, of forgiveness, it's not so much, I think, expressed in the figure of Jean Valjean, but in the character of the bishop. And one of the things that Victor Hugo does is he has these great long chapters of diversion that really has nothing to do with the story. And in it, he goes into the life of this bishop. And I noticed that in the chancel over there, there's a rather lovely plaque from a former dean of this cathedral who left all his money to the cathedral. And then in the inscription, it says a note to his successors that it would be a form of sacrilege not to leave all their money to the cathedral as well when they die. Tim, over to you. But it was that sense of that Victor Hugo spends so much time describing the life of the bishop. He has an income of 15,000. He gives 14,000 of it to the poor. He has a huge palace next to the hospital for the poor. And he swaps. He says, no, get the patients. They can have this house and we'll move into the small house. He walks round or rides in a donkey. Interestingly, the life of a lot of our saints, like St. Chad and St. Martin, the great bishops, tell similar stories. And here's this character of the bishop, and he's the one who, in a moment of grace, of forgiveness, of love, gives Jean Valjean a new chance, a fresh start at the point he needs it. But that's not where this quote, the quote you've chosen, came from. The quote actually comes from the very end of the bishop's life, and it's describing his death. The bishop dies at the end of his life, and he's talking about, Victor Hugo describes his life just before he dies. He's living with his sister. His sister's cared for him all the way through his ministry. He's gone blind, and he says that he had a supreme happiness that can only come from knowing how much loved you are, from loving someone else so complete, of knowing that you are loved for who you are, despite who you are loved. And he describes that's the love of the sister that cares for the bishop and the bishop that cares for his sister. And at the end of his life, he reaches the end of his life in that situation of love. So two readings that you've chosen. I kind of, as I read them, I was thinking, well, it's odd. The Church of England often gets accused of what we do is hatch 'em, match 'em, and dispatch 'em. Or as my dad used to say, starters, martyrs, and departers, which is a joke that my mum used to find less funny than he did for some reason. And it almost seems to me that what you've picked is two readings, one that would be great for a baptism, and the other would be great at the other end. With the Matthew reading, it's choosing the values that you set out with. What Jesus says to his disciples is, choose your values, build your life on the values. Every couple... I'm getting upstaged here, aren't I? She's doing what everyone else is thinking, which is time for me to shut up. Choose your values. Jesus says, Build your life on these things. Every couple has a set of shared values that they've chosen consciously or unconsciously. So when the two of you set off on this, or continue on this journey, set on of married life together, choosing those values that Jesus expresses in the Sermon on the Mount as a new beginning is a great place to start. And the second reading, that reading from Les Miserables, from the end of the life of the bishop, that love that is so known and loved and accepted for who they are. Know, have that picture in your mind as that's where you're aiming for. In 40, 50, 60, 70 years, whenever it is. The vows that you say, till death do us part. When you get to that point, know what it is you're aiming for. That form of love so deep and so complete that the two of you are known by each other, that you trust each other, that you accepted for who you are, and love that is so powerful and strong that gets you through that. So choose your values. Base this life you have on together on that teaching of Jesus, and you won't go far wrong. Know where you're heading, what it is you want from this relationship, from the journey that you're on. And every day, as that reading from Les Mis said, do the small acts of kindness and love that will help you get there. And know that on that journey, that you'll be surrounded by God's love, which has been shown supremely through Jesus' own act of sacrificial love as he died on the cross and lived again for us. Know that your love is supported and carried by his love for you. Amen.
To the world.
Beth and Ben, I now invite you to join hands and make your solemn vows in the presence of God and his people. Ben, you're going to say these words to Beth. I, Benjamin Mark, take you, Bethany Hope.
I, Benjamin Mark, take you, Bethany Hope.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God I make this vow.
In the presence of God I make this vow.
Would you please loose hands? Now, Beth, I invite you to take Ben's right hand in yours. And you say to him, I, Bethany Hope, take you, Benjamin Mark.
I, Bethany Hope, take you, Benjamin Mark.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God, I make this vow.
In the presence of God, I make this vow.
Please loose hands. We're going to step to one side, and members of your family are going to come and hold the rings you're to exchange and say some words as they do so. I invite John and Elaine to come to the microphone first.
May these rings be a symbol to both of you of unending love and joy.
Can I have the last word?
You always do.
A good marriage is like a good wine. The longer you keep it, the better it is. And we've just celebrated 65 years, and I think you're George and June have done the same, haven't they? Yes.
Nice and close.
As you begin your life together as husband and wife, remember to accept each other's flaws, along with accepting each other's perfections. Wishing you both a long and happy marriage full of love, fun, laughter, and adventure.
I'm going to read it. Bless these rings, Lord, that when given to each other, we will bring Beth and Ben a long and happy life together.
Ben and Beth, as you enter this special world of married life and run together in love, always remember that love is the many splendid thing that you need to work at. When it is given and received from each other, it will enrich your lives. When you love each other unconditionally, nothing in the world is too difficult, and doing things for each other become effortless. Even the roughest times become smooth when you travel hand in hand. May God bless these rings as they encircle your fingers and your hearts, and that the value of these rings surpass that of gold and diamonds and become the symbol of the priceless commitment of the covenant of marriage. We hope that you will be as happy as we are after 41 years. May God's love and your faith be with you both always.
Laugh, enjoy each other, have fun, give each other time, give each other your support and loyalty, but most of all, just love each other and have fun.
Heavenly Father, by your blessing, let these rings be to Ben and Beth a symbol of unending love and faithfulness to remind them of the vow and covenant which they have made this day through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Ben, please place the ring on the fourth finger of Beth's left hand. And as you hold it there, you say these words to her. Beth, I give you this ring.
Beth, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honor you.
With my body, I honor you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Now pop the ring all the way on, carefully.
Just jab it on.
Partly on to the fourth finger of Ben's left hand, and you're saying these words to him. Ben, I give you this ring.
Ben, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honor you.
With my body, I honor you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Pop the ring all the way up.
His knuckles are too big.
Ben has abnormally large knuckles on abnormally slender fingers. In the presence of God and before this congregation, Beth and Ben have given their consent and made their marriage vows to each other. They have declared their marriage by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of rings. I therefore proclaim that they are husband and wife. Can we give them a round of applause? Can I have your right hands, please? I'm just going to... this stole that I've wrapped around their hands is a stole that Ben and Beth bought for me from Ghana, so it kind of belongs to the three of us. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Two prayers of blessing for you. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, for you have created joy and gladness, pleasure and delight, love, peace and fellowship. Pour out the abundance of your blessing upon Ben and Beth in their new life together. Let their love for each other be a seal upon their hearts and a crown upon their heads. Bless them in their work and in their companionship, awake and asleep, in joy and in sorrow, in life and in death. Finally, in your mercy, bring them to that banquet where your saints feast forever in your heavenly home. We ask this through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord mercifully grant you the riches of his grace, that you may please him both in body and soul, and living together in faith and love, may receive the blessings of eternal life. Amen. The congregation, please be seated as we go to register their new marriage. You're going to lead us.
the prayers which follow, the response, "Hear our prayer," comes immediately after, "Lord of life and love." Faithful God, holy and eternal, source of life and spring of love, we thank and praise you for bringing Ben and Beth to this day, and we pray for them. Lord of life and love, may their marriage be life-giving and lifelong, enriched by your presence and strengthened by your grace. May they bring comfort and confidence to each other in faithfulness and trust. Lord of life and love, may the hospitality of their home bring refreshment and joy to all around them. May their love overflow to neighbors in need and embrace those in distress. Lord of life and love, may they discern in your word order and purpose for their lives. And may the power of your Holy Spirit lead them in truth and defend them in adversity. Lord of life and love, may they nurture their family with devotion. See their children grow in body, mind, and spirit, and come at last to the end of their lives with heart content and in joyful anticipation of heaven. Lord of life and love, let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Amen.
As soon as I got back to the seat after the signing of the registers, Jeremy said to me, "When are they going to do the kiss?" The groom may now kiss his bride. I have a couple of other things to say to you before the final blessing. What we're going to do in the recessional music is invite the whole congregation to join us at the west doors. As efficiently and speedily as you can manage, please. There's going to be a photograph of you all with Ben and Beth and confetti at the west doors. It doesn't end there. You're then asked, please come back here, because by that time, the photographer will have ascended the dizzy heights of the gallery. He's not there yet. And we will have a group photo of everybody in here. Following that, into the cathedral garth, the gardens in the middle of the cloisters, and there will be a drinks reception. I think that's all I needed to say, isn't it? I've done it all. We've got away with it. They're smiling. It's all good. Some words of blessing as we conclude our time together here in the choir. Prayer for you all, each and every one of you here. God, the Holy Trinity, make you strong in faith and love. Defend you on every side and guide you in truth and peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.